Today we will have a look on PTGUI and XML import for Hyperlight Panorama. So first of all we have to import the images and then the XML file, and after that we can create the panorama. I use the Mavic 2 Pro to shoot this panorama, and the pitch gimbal was plus 25 degrees. So now let's correct the exposure settings. As we use Hyperlight, it goes up to 1600 ISO, and then we have to correct the sky images. So now let's save the panorama. And then we will have a look how we can fix the zenith. I will use the square method to do so. So the next point is that we import the calculated panorama. Now we can export the squares. The panorama will be converted to 6 cubes, and we can edit the nadir or the zenith cube. Here you can see the zenith cube, so I select the hole and I will autofill the hole. This method works in Photoshop and also in Photoshop Elements. The Adobe Fill method works with artificial intelligence. So the result is quite amazing. Now we can fine adjust the zenith cube. For night shootings it's not possible to use the zenith method, as we held the aircraft in the hand and we cannot exposure more than 1 second, so it's impossible to do so. Now we will save the cube and re-import in PTGUI. Now in PTGUI we have to create a new session. We import 6 cubes, and since the version 11 all is automatic. The program recognizes that we have 6 cubes, and then we can recreate the panorama. I finally adjust the pixel settings and then let's calculate the panorama. The final tone map settings for the sky are made in Photoshop again. So let's duplicate and then change the tone mapping so that we have the right lights for the sky. You need to play with that until you have the right settings with the sky. And then finally we can save the panorama. For Windows user we have a different method. I prefer the supercubic method, where I can create the squares directly in Photoshop. With the version 2 of supercubic we have multiprocessor treating, so it's very fast to do so even with big images. We create a cube from the nadir and the zenith, and then we can correct the nadir and the zenith. It's similar to the previous method, but it's even faster, as we can all do in Photoshop. So I select the hole, that's the same method, then I autofill the hole. And the artificial intelligence from Photoshop is really amazing. The hole is more than 60% of the image, but the algorithm is working very well. I will do some final adjustments for the sky. And then I will also add a text for the nadir shot. That's really easy with this supercubic method. You can see we have two squares. Now I will go to the Nardi square and add the text. I will zoom in and use this street to add a text on this round point. Normally I adjust the colors to have small differences between the panorama colors and the text colors. And then we are done and we can recalculate the original image with Supercubic Reverse. I use overlap from 5 pixels. So it's very easy to use, but unfortunately only for Windows users. And then I will finally adjust the tone mapping for the sky as before for the PTGUI image. And then we will have a final panorama. With PTGUI we have a good alternative to AutoPano from color. And with the cubic method we can also on Mac computers do the same as on Windows with the Supercubic method. We can fix the nadir and the zenith. So let's have a look on the final result of this night shooting. You can see on this night shooting the Rolex movement manufacturing facility. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Until the next time, thank you for watching.